The key invention of blockchain and cryptocurrencies is the consensus mechanism. In this video, I discuss how coming to consensus over shared facts is a problem that has been the overriding concern of economists and political philosophers for centuries. At the heart of Satoshi Nakamoto's invention, Bitcoin, is its consensus mechanism. All blockchains need some way to come to agreement about what the contents of their shared ledger is. All blockchains need a way for the network to agree which transactions to add and in which order. In a centralized system, that agreement is easy to come by. A central authority holds a master copy of the ledger, notifies everyone of changes to the ledger, and ensures everyone is keeping an accurate copy. But central authorities aren't always trustworthy, and central authorities are a single point of failure or a target for attackers. Satoshi Nakamoto needed a way to come to agreement without that central authority. Another way to think about this is called the Byzantine Generals Problem. Imagine a Byzantine army is surrounding a castle on all sides. The army is organized into divisions, each led by a general of equivalent rank. How can the generals come to agreement about when they should attack the castle? Communication between each general is imperfect. That communication might be intercepted by the enemy. Even worse, some of the generals might be corrupt. They might want to intentionally disrupt or undermine the coordinated offensive. The Byzantine Generals Problem describes the challenge of achieving a consensus in a distributed, decentralized system when information flows imperfectly and in the presence of adversaries. Satoshi Nakamoto solved the consensus problem in blockchains by using what's called a proof-of-work puzzle. Essentially, miners compete against each other to solve a computationally difficult puzzle. The winner of the contest has the right to group new transactions into a new block for the network and claim a reward in Bitcoin for their trouble. The idea is that it's more profitable to look after the network than try to attack it. For a large popular network like Bitcoin, the proof-of-work consensus mechanism is very robust. It solves the Byzantine Generals problem, but it's also slow and inefficient, and it uses a lot of energy. A number of blockchains, then, have been experimenting with alternative consensus mechanisms that might speed up the process and reduce energy waste. For example, proof-of-stake mechanisms ask validators to stake a certain amount of cryptocurrency in exchange for rewards, and at risk of confiscation if they undermine the network. Other approaches, such as practical or distributed Byzantine fault-tolerant networks, allow token holders to vote on who will validate new transactions. These are technical issues, and there's enormous amount of work on crypto economics and computer science going into developing better, more robust, more efficient consensus mechanisms. But I want to point out that in a very real sense, the consensus mechanism, the Byzantine Generals problem, is the basic problem of all human activity, not just blockchains, the economy and society in general. We need to coordinate our activities with each other, to work together, to make trades, and to build prosperous countries. But information flows imperfectly, and some people might act opportunistically. The Byzantine Generals problem comes from the field of computer science, but it turns out it's a restatement of the overriding concern of economics and political philosophy.